JP Publication introducing digital platform for learning with Education House. Download the application Education House from Google Play Store and follow us on Facebook, YouTube and WhatsApp. Hello friends, in this video we will learn about anti-inflationary policy, means how to control the inflation, in which we will learn about meaning of anti-inflationary policy and the various measures or the steps is taken for a control of inflation we will learn. Let's see meaning of anti-inflationary policy. The policy which control the inflation is known as anti-inflationary policy. To control the inflation, there are two different types of measures is to be taken. Number first, measures to control aggregate expenditure or aggregate demand, and measure to increase the production and supply of goods and services. By this way, we can control over the inflation situation. Let's see. Measure to control aggregate expenditures or demand. Normally, ये आपको पता है कि जब भी demand बढ़ती है, expenditure बढ़ता है, तो उससे inflation बढ़ता है. लेकिन डिमांड और एक्सपेंडिचर को हम कंट्रोल में करने के लिए ये सब मेजर्स यूज कर सकते हैं, जैसे कि मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी, फिस्कल पॉलिसी, प्राइस कंट्रोल्स एंड रेशनिंग एंड वेज फ्रीज पॉलिसी. दोज आर द मेन एग्रीगेटेड मेजर विच आर हेल्पफुल टू रिड्यूसेस द इन्फ्लेशन. लेट्स सी नंबर फर्स्ट, मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी. द पॉलिसी विच इज फॉर्मुलेटेड बाय द गवर्नर ऑफ RBI, which is known as a monetary policy, which affect to the supply and demand of money into the market. According to this policy, whenever the inflation incurred into the market, at that time, Reserve Bank of India try to increase the rate of interest. So, automatically, loan is to be reduced and supply of money can be contracted from the market. This type of policy is considered as a tight money policy or a dear money policy, which have the mainly intention to control or to contractions of the bank credit. If bank credit reduces, automatically the supply of money reduces. So Reserve Bank क्या करती है? ऐसा कुछ करती है जिससे rate of interest बढ़ जाए, जिससे सब loan लेने कम आए और market में जो पैसा है, supply of money है, उसे वो bank में FD के तौर पर डाल दे. So, according to this way, money can be contracted, means supply of money reduce hota hai. By this way, Reserve Bank of India accept monetary policy. Number of steps is to be taken, like the central bank increases the bank rate, central bank sells the security in the open markets, central bank directs the commercial banks to increase the cash reserve ratio, which they have to keep within, just like CRR. And the central bank impose credit control measure like credit rationing. तो ये चार तरह से Reserve Bank of India यानी central bank credit पर control लाती है और supply of money को कम करती है, जिससे inflation कम हो सके. Number second thing is fiscal policies. Fiscal policy shows the government taxation, public expenditure, public borrowing and all the things, which is also connected as an budget. Or the policy which refers to the public expenditure and public borrowings and public income, then it is called as an fiscal policy. Here, number of different factors or the steps is given regarding the fiscal policy. Jo policy government ke income or expenditures ko control karti hai, us policy ko hum fiscal policy bolte hai. It is just like the budget. Let's see some factors of fiscal policies. Number first, reduction in a public expenditure. If government want to reduce the situation of inflation and price rise, then they always try to reduce the public expenditure. Whatever spending they have to made for the infrastructure, for weapons and for development oriented way, they have to control. If public expense is stopped from the market, automatically income of the people reduces and inflations can be controlled. So by this way, reduction in public expenditure become helpful to control inflation. Simple baat ye aapko pata hai ki market mein supply of money badhne se inflation badhta hai. तो सप्लाई ऑफ मनी कहाँ से आता था? गवर्नमेंट के पब्लिक एक्सपेंडिचर से। लेकिन जब गवर्नमेंट ही पब्लिक एक्सपेंडिचर कम कर दे तो पब्लिक के पास कम पैसे आएंगे, पब्लिक के पास कम पैसे आएंगे तो इन्फ्लेशन कंट्रोल में हो जाएगा। अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वे इन्फ्लेशन कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड। अनदर इज इंक्रीज इन टैक्सेस। इफ गवर्नमेंट रेजेस द टैक्सेस ऑन द पीपल then automatically consumption capacity or purchasing capacity of the population reduces. So people not demanding more and more goods as well as government can earn the benefits of income. So supply of money diversified from market to government and automatically demand level reduces. Purchasing power capacity of consumer reduces and so this way inflation controlled. So, जैसे गवर्नमेंट टैक्स बढ़ाती है तो पब्लिक की जो खर्ची है वो कम हो जाती है, यानी पब्लिक का जो स्पेंडिंग है वो कम हो जाता है, तो उससे भी डिमांड कम होगी और मार्केट में इन्फ्लेशन कंट्रोल में आएगा। और दूसरी चीज कि पब्लिक की जो इनकम थी वो टैक्स बढ़ने से ज्यादातर इनकम टैक्स में चली जाएगी, ऑटोमेटिकली गवर्नमेंट को पैसे भी मिलेंगे और मार्केट में से सप्लाई ऑफ मनी कम भी होगा। थ्रू दिस वे गवर्नमेंट कंट्रोल इन्फ्लेशन। अनदर इज पब्लिक बोरोइंग्स। Government always try in an inflation period to get the borrowings. For that purpose, all of you know that as per the monetary policy, Reserve Bank of India increases the rate of interest. So people don't want to take the loan, but they have to make some FD or making time deposits. So public borrowings increases, means government get the fund from the market through various bank and non-banking sources. So automatically the supply of money reduces into the market, and even if government also applies some incentive schemes to encourage the people savings, so automatically the supply of money reduced and inflation can be controlled. Government hamesha aisa try karti hai ki jisse inflation mein rate of interest badh jaye, to public loan nahi legi lekin kya karegi, FD karwayengi ya long term deposit karwayengi। तो ये जो लॉन्ग टर्म डिपॉजिट करवाएगी वो सभी पैसे जाएंगे गवर्नमेंट के पास, यानी वो पब्लिक बोरिंग हो जाएगी और अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वे इन्फ्लेशन कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड। सो दोस ऑल आर द टॉपिक रिलेवेंट विद द फिस्कल पॉलिसी। लेट्स सी प्राइस कंट्रोल्स एंड रेशनिंग। प्राइस कंट्रोल एंड रेशनिंग ऑल्सो ऑक्यूपाइड द इम्पॉर्टेंट प्लेस एज एंटी इन्फ्लेशनरी मेजर। If government have to apply some price control and regulation by their own ways, by indirect and direct measure, automatically the price are controlled. Sometime government control the pricing by controlling on excise duty, controlling by taxation system, controlling by subsidiaries. Those all are the different types of the way where government can control over the price. And if prices are controlled, then automatically inflations can be controlled from the market. तो जब भी प्राइस कंट्रोल में रखना पड़ता है या गवर्नमेंट ऐसे स्टेप लेता है जैसे प्राइस को कंट्रोल में किया जाए तो इन्फ्लेशन कम होगा। तो गवर्नमेंट उसके लिए डायरेक्ट इनडायरेक्ट स्टेप्स ले सकता है। एंड जस्ट लाइक इट इज ऑब्जर्व दैट कि जब भी किसी प्रोडक्ट के दाम को कंट्रोल करना होता है तो गवर्नमेंट उस पर सब्सिडीज देती है या उसके एक्साइज ड्यूटी कम कर देती है। सो बाय दिस वे गवर्नमेंट कैन कंट्रोल ओवर द इन्फ्लेशन। अनदर इज वेज फ्रीज पॉलिसी। एक्चुअली वेज फ्रीज पॉलिसी इज डिफिकल्ट टू अप्लाई, बट इट इज अ सुपीरियर स्टेप टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द इनकम इन अ प्रॉपर मैनर and control over the unequal distribution of income and wealth. Means, one person are not liable to earn a lakh rupees, but 5 persons are liable to get 20,000 rupees. This is a wage freeze policy. Means, according to this policy, the higher standard salaries reduces and number of people getting normal salaries employed. So according to this way, wages level can be controlled and people have get the proper employment. So ye policy ki tarah se government koi bhi government employees ya any self finance sectors ke jo salaries hai usse badhaye nahi, usse control mein rakhe. Yadi usse control mein rakhti hai to automatically uski jo purchasing capacity hoti hai consumer ki aur employees ki wo kam ho jati hai. So that will be helpful for inflation control. But this policy create the negativity in the union leaders of the employees. And so that's why reason it is too much risky task or risky step to apply this policy in a real life. By this way, government can control the inflations. So those all are the different steps is taken by the government for control over the aggregated demand or the cost of production. Let's see the second. Increase the domestic supplies of the essential goods. Number first, increased imports and reduced export. When in the market inflation is incurred, at that time government tried to control the inflation by increasing in import and reduction in export. If our export will reduces, then automatically more foreign currencies cannot be received by the country and price flow is controlled or inflow of the money can be easily controlled. So supply of money is controlled from the market. And whenever we make the import, our fund is to be outfloated, so automatically supply of money can be reduces from the market. But sometimes it is not helpful for the economy because increase in import and reduction in exports will create the problems in the balance of payment. It will be the create the problems in a deficit balance of payment. So that's why reason sometimes it's not a both side win-win situation, but it is the critical situations for control over the inflation. But for a normal way, government can apply these strategies and control over the inflation. Another is increase production. Every time government try to increase the production by expanding and promoting the different industrial sectors. If production will raises, then automatically the supply will raises. In a context of demand, if sufficient supply is available, then there will be no possibilities of any scarcity. So if scarcity will not arises, automatically the price can be controlled. And this way, inflations can be controlled. क्योंकि सिंपल लॉजिक है, आपको पता है कि जब भी मार्केट में डिमांड बढ़ती है बट सप्लाई नहीं होती तो ही स्कैर्सिटी होती है. लेकिन गवर्नमेंट प्रोडक्शन बढ़ाने पर फोकस करेगी. यदि प्रोडक्शन अच्छे से बढ़ेगा तो मार्केट में सप्लाई बढ़ेगा और सप्लाई बढ़ेगा तो किसी की चीज की भी स्कैर्सिटी नहीं होगी, विच विल बी हेल्पफुल. वो बहुत अच्छे से बेनिफिटेड होगा कि जिससे इकोनॉमी कैन बी रिवाइव. सो इंक्रीज इन प्रोडक्शन कैन हेल्पफुल टू कंट्रोल द इन्फ्लेशन. In short, those all are the different types of steps is to be taken for a control over the inflation. But if this type of step is to be taken by strict manner, then again it will be create the recession into the market. So they have a positive as well as some negative factors or the matters which are affecting to the inflation. Inflation is the hydra-headed monster and should be fought with the many weapons. Reliance on a single matter of control may not prove the effectives. So those all are a number of steps is taken to control the inflation. By this way, inflation can be controlled and this type of policy is considered as a anti-inflationary policy.